I'm gonna tell you a fable. A king, growing old, has two daughters and wants to partition his land. He goes to his counselor and says, "Counselor, I have four pieces of land and two daughters, and I want to partition my land equally amongst my daughters. My surveyor says that the land masses I have are of this shape. I have one triangular piece of land, and it has a square angle here." "A right angle," says the counselor. "You have a right angle triangle." "Ah, a right angle triangle. And then I have a square piece of land whose edge is the side of the longest side of my triangle. And I have another whose edge is the side of this side of the triangle, and a third the side of this side of the triangle." The surveyor tells me they're all squares. The counselor says, "Oh, no problem. Don't be one of these foolish kings who gives away all your land. Keep that triangular piece for yourself. Give the largest square to one of your daughters, and the two small squares to the other daughter. It'll be perfectly even." "That's easy," says the king, and he's about to leave, but then says, "Counselor, I haven't told you anything about how long the sides of these squares are, or the shape of the triangle." Counselor says, "Don't worry. What we have here is three squares, one triangle. If the edges of these pieces of land are doubled, all the areas get multiplied by four. If they're tripled, all the areas get multiplied by nine. That's three squared. If you change all the lengths of your figures by some factor, the area is changed by the square of the factor, and so the proportions are exactly the same." The counselor says, "This is called scaling and similarity. If you scale your figures in this way, you get similar figures. Scaling a length by some factor scales the area by the square." "Wonderful," says the king. The king walks away, but even before he leaves the room, he says, "But I didn't tell you what the angles of the triangle." Counselor says, "That doesn't matter. What we have here is something called the Pythagorean theorem. It doesn't matter what the angles are, as long as one of those angles is a right angle." King leaves, returns the next day, distraught, and says, "My surveyor tells me I don't have squares. I have things that he called blobs. That is, I have a triangle, a right angle triangle. I have three fields. Each landmass has one linear edge, the linear edge equal to the edge of the corresponding edge of the triangle. And he also tells me that my blobs are similar. If I scale any one of these blobs appropriately, it will become any of the others. Now what do I do?" asks the king apprehensively, and the counselor says, "No problem. Do exactly as before. You keep your triangle, give the largest blob mass to one of your daughters, and the other two to the other daughter, and it'll be even, Stephen." The king is amazed. He says, "It doesn't matter what blobs they are, as long as they're similar." The counselor says, "Yes. What do you call that?" says the king. "Oh, I call that the blob Pythagorean theorem." "For every blob, there's a blob Pythagorean theorem?" says the king. "Strange," the counselor says. "Yes, and not only that, but if you know the blob Pythagorean theorem for any blob, you know it for every blob." The king says, How can that be?" Well, the counselor says, look at this. You have three blobs here. Imagine that there's what I'll call a unit blob, that is, say, a blob that's similar to it, but its length is one. Let us say the length of its straight edge is one. Why then, if the length of this straight edge is C, and the length of this straight edge is A, and the length of this straight edge is B, Then we know that whatever area this blob has, let me call the area of that blob capital A, the area of the unit blob. The area of this blob is the square of the factor that one needs in order to scale the unit blob to it. So the area will be C squared times A. The area of this will be A squared times A, and the area of this will be B squared times A. So if I prove to you that for some blob with some area A, this large blob is the sum in area of the areas of these two small ones, what I will have shown is C squared times A is equal to A squared times A plus B squared times A. And canceling out the A's, I have C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. And so if you give me any other blob, I will get exactly the same result. So one blob, Pythagorean theorem implies Pythagorean theorem for all blobs, says the king. And he leaves sort of contented. King comes in day three and says, "It's wonderful what you've told me, what you've explained to me, but can you show me the blob Pythagorean theorem for some blob? In which case, I'll know it for all." Counselor says, "Oh, well, for that, you have to draw me a right angle triangle." And the counselor says, "Ah, well, so my job then would be to produce a blob with a linear side of length C. A blob with a linear side of length B, that blob being similar to the blob of length C, and a blob with length A similar to the other two. And then I will have to show you that the area of the largest of these blobs is the sum of the area of the other two blobs." The king says, "Well, yes, this might be quite a chore." The counselor says, "Well, try this." The counselor draws a single line which meets the large side in a right angle. And then steps back and says, "There you are." "Where am I?" says the king. "The blob whose linear edge is C is the entire triangle. The blob whose linear edge is B is the triangle to the right. The blob whose linear edge is A is the triangle to the left. All these triangles are right-angled triangles because one of their angles is a right angle. Each of these triangles have another angle in common. For example, this large triangle has this angle in common with this one, and it has this angle in common with this one. All three right-angled triangles are similar." So those are my three blobs, and to see that the sum of the two small blobs is equal to the large blob is evident. King says, "Ah." Okay, so now what's my moral? Can you guess?
I don't know, that kings ask a lot of questions.